I am really frustrated right now, but I'm trying to be grateful. Do you call 11:30, 11:20 in the morning, the afternoon? When I say afternoon, I mean 12 at the earliest. 1, 2, 3, 4. You had from 1 to 4. There's no reason you couldn't have either set it up then or told me there's no one available during that time. The real NV87? The blind NV87? The NV87 who doesn't care what the screen looks like. I'm headed home in a minute here. Awesome, that's exactly what I was hoping to hear. 11:20, okay. Okay, I hope that works out with the rest of the way life goes. I told them afternoon. When I told them afternoon, I was thinking more along the lines of, yeah, like, this window is 10 to 12, and I would like that time to be, you know, come and gone before you guys show up, but I... Now I'm in a situation where it's set up, and it's either take it or cancel it. I'll just have to take it and hope that... I mean, sometimes they show up early or within the 10 o'clock hour. Hopefully they will this time if it turns out that... Yeah. It's just that they could show up between 10 and 12, and I'd like to not leave right in the middle of that, you know? I want to go bad enough, and I'm really not... I'm not interested in saying, screw it, we'll not do this, but so... I'll just take it and hope for the best, but... What should I have said so this wouldn't have happened? Okay, well... Next time I'll tell them... sometime after 1. I'm flexible, but don't make it, like... I mean, I'd rather have a trip than no trip, so, I mean, I'll take it, and I'm glad you guys were able to set something up. I just... They had from 1 to 4, from 1 to 5, and they could have set any time up that would have worked, and this is what they give me. I mean, I can see what they say. I've never tried that. I've always, when I knew I had an appointment that I couldn't get out of right in the middle of that window, I just didn't place an order. But now here I am having placed one, so... Yeah, well... Yeah, hopefully, if it doesn't, yeah. Yeah, thanks. Bye. I am really frustrated right now, but I'm trying to be grateful. Because I know that it could have turned out just... I could have turned out totally screwed. I could have turned out... It's either take door-to-door transit, or... Don't go when you want to go, because my preferred ride service does sometimes tell me we do not have anyone available to take you at all. What they told me was, we've got someone available, but here's when we're going to be able to pick you up. And I'm like, okay, when I told the people who schedule you guys' rides what I wanted, I did not mean to suggest that that was an acceptable time. You know... For however many of you actually bother to watch my videos, I'm such a gripey bitch right now. For the few of you that actually do watch, do you call 11:30, 11:20 in the morning, the afternoon? I don't. Does anybody else, or am I the only crazy person that thinks that's still in the morning? When I say afternoon, I mean 12 at the earliest. 1, 2, 3, 4. You had from 1 to 4. There's no reason you couldn't have either set it up then or told me there's no one available during that time. They're like, well, can you call the grocery delivery service and see if they'll come in early? I'm like, as far as I know, they don't promise that, but I would like to be there when this grocery delivery shows up. And hopefully I will be, because sometimes they do show up. I mean, by the time they're picking me up, there's only 40 minutes left in the 2-hour window. But still, when I say the afternoon, I don't mean freaking 11:30. Hello? Or am I the only one who calls morning from dawn to noon? Afternoon means after noon. I mean, am I wrong? Good morning.
Crook time, not set, set. Crook time, minutes. 1, 5, 10 minutes.
Whoa.
9, 5, 0 minutes. Power level high. 1 minute, 30 seconds. Microwave running.
There. All right, so the third party place that schedules this organization's rides, why can't they schedule their own rides? They used to be able to. Now, most if not all of the scheduling things, they say you need to call this place for that. I'm like, why? They're competent people. They got a good computer system. Why do I have to call other people to schedule what I want done? Anyway, their third-party schedulers screwed up. When I called to reserve or request my ride for tomorrow, I said, I'm flexible, but I need it to happen in the afternoon. At least that's what I thought I said. Obviously, that's not what they heard, because they're coming at 11:20 to get me and take me to this store and come back at 12:10 to pick me up and take me home. I'm like, 11:20 in the morning. Of course, I didn't say this on the phone, but I'm like, you call that afternoon? 12:20, I call afternoon. 1:20, I call afternoon. 11:20, I call in the morning, and I told you guys afternoon. She did look at the driver's schedule, but there's no wiggle room. They're going to have to just do it the way it's written, or I'm going to have to say forget it. Just, I'll figure out another way, or I'll do it next week or something. Well, I'm not going to try to do it next week because I've got a doctor's appointment. Nothing serious, it's just routine. But I'm not going to try to do that and go to this phone store at the same time. So I'm going to have to just go when I can go and hope that, I mean, the grocery delivery, that's why it's a big deal. That's why I care. My assistant's coming first thing in the morning. Actually, she'll probably be out of here by like 10. But anyway, she will have come and gone before they try to show up. But the store, the grocery delivery that comes every Thursday, unless I either haven't placed an order or it's a day that they've taken off, which there's going to be some of. We're into the holiday season, remember? Well, their time for delivery, their delivery window is between 10 a.m. and 12 p.m. I'd kind of like to be there during that time to accept what they have to bring me, because sometimes I'll get lucky and they'll show up at 10 o'clock or 10:30. And the endless alarms begin.
Screen time. Wednesday, December 4th.
sometimes they do show up at 10 or 10:30, but sometimes it's not till like 11 or 11:30 before they get here. And if that happens, I would like to be there. Which is why I told them I want to be picked up in the afternoon. Well, apparently they heard I'm flexible, but I kind of want the afternoon to myself. I don't know what the hell they heard. I just know they gave me something that still gives me most of the afternoon, which is fine, but they pick me up right when I don't want them to. So it's either call them back, tell them to forget it, call them again, call the schedulers again and say, I want to set this up now for December 19th or something, and let's be good and clear. I'm flexible, maybe that's part of the problem. I didn't have a set appointment time, so. So telling them flexibility, you know, being willing to be flexible might be my undoing. I suppose I could call them and tell them, never mind, and then call those schedulers back and say, let's talk about the 19th. Here's where I want to go. Here's when I want to go there. I don't necessarily have to be there at a particular time, but here's how long I need. Here's what time I want to be at my house. Don't send someone there before then. Do you understand me? I'm not going to word it like that. But if I have to be that assertive, then that's what I'll do. I mean, I really do appreciate this service. I would be really kind of at a disadvantage without them. But this scheduling mess is just not something I'm very happy about. And again, why must these other people schedule for them? I've been working with them for over a decade. I'm not sure when I got set up with them, but they did not always have other schedulers. Why do they have other schedulers? Even the other schedulers has done a pretty good job, but not this time. Anyway, we're going to move on to today. That's tomorrow that I'm trying to figure out how to deal with. Right now, it's Wednesday, just after 8. I've got a ride coming in. Let's find out exactly. Alexa, what time is it?
The time is 8:04 a.m. And good morning.
Half an hour. I was afraid this was going to happen when they told me my window was 8:30 to 9. It's 9:05. It's not 9:05 right now. It's going to be 9:05 according to the ETA before they're here. I'm like, do we have other places to go or am I going straight to where I'm going? And they say I'm going straight to where I'm going, so that makes me feel a little bit better about it. I mean, leaving at 9:05 is not a whole lot different from what I do sometimes with my preferred ride service. So hopefully it'll all work out. It's just, yeah, it'll be fine. I'm just going to believe that it's going to be fine. Okay, technically I've got 4 minutes that I could just stay here according to the ETA, but I think I'm going to go ahead and step outside and, like, be out there when they show up. That way it's just as easy to just connect with them. By that I mean they don't have to go into the foyer and try to call me on the security system. I'll be standing right out there. By the time I get done editing, I wonder how much of this I'm going to keep. I'll probably keep some of today and then really do most of the vlogging tomorrow, like between 10 o'clock and whatever time I get back from the phone store. Which they're taking me to too early, but hopefully it doesn't matter because hopefully come 10:30 or so, this grocery delivery person will show up and the issue will be resolved. But I'd feel better about leaving things to chance if they would have gotten it correct. I'm not going to stand here and make you listen to 4 minutes of outside noise while I wait, so. Okay, I did not vlog any of it, but this has gone off without a hitch. It happened exactly like I was hoping that it would. They pulled right up. They knew they were there for me, so they talked to me. you know, and I was waiting right there, so all they had to do was open the door and say something, and I was set up. Okay.
9:36 a.m.
I got here with literally 20 minutes to spare. Good deal. What happened was, I didn't vlog any of it, but I got into the vehicle. Thought I recognized this person's voice, but I guess she hasn't had me before. But either way, I said, "You've been to this place before, haven't you?" Because I thought she sounded familiar. But she's like, "Actually, I haven't been to this particular location that you're going to." I'm like, "Okay, then you need this. We have been through so much in the year and a half that I have been working at this location. My coworkers finally wrote me up a list of instructions, a map, a list of instructions to drivers when you get lost. But I don't need to be on one side of the vehicle and there, all the way up in the front at the driver's side, going, okay, here's where I am. How do I get to where you're going from here?" I don't know how to answer that, but I'm a little more prepared for that now because now I have a paper that I carry around every time I go to work. But I don't want to have to figure out how to get it to them in the front of the bus. I mean, my arm's not long enough to reach them way up there and say, "Here," like, hand it to them. So if they need to see this map, that's the time to give it to them before we even start. So this worked out perfectly. I'm at work. I'm probably going to have another nothing to vlog kind of work day, because that's just kind of the way my work days are. And I'll see you actually probably tomorrow when I deal with this whole, you call that afternoon situation with trying to go to the phone store. Okay, today is the day. The question of the day: will my grocery delivery service show up early enough that when my very badly scheduled ride shows up at 11:20, my groceries are delivered, and I can leave my apartment without worrying about it? Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. Let's hope this time they do, because there's really nothing I can do about it. What scheduler calls 11:20 in the morning, afternoon? I mean, really? And did I allow myself enough time at this store? I assume it's going to be easy, but will it be? It should be. I didn't allow myself a whole lot of time to, like, have complications come up. But I'm just going to believe the best, and that, first of all, they're going to show up when I need them to show up. The grocery delivery service, that is. And then when I arrive, they'll be prepared to just give me a number, throw a SIM card in this phone, and we're off and going. I don't know. It's 10:46 and they're not here yet. They still have some time. Thank goodness, as soon as I say that, they show up. Whew, okay, we got lucky. This grocery delivery has come and gone with 20 minutes to spare. It worked out this time, but I guess in the future, I'm going to have to assume that a scheduler doesn't necessarily know what afternoon means and just outright say, I can be flexible to a certain extent, don't show up before like 1. But now, that has worked out, and it's on to the phone / cable TV store to hopefully get a new phone. Well, not to get a new phone, but to get a new phone. Get a new phone without having to buy a new phone, you know what I mean? Take a iPhone that has no cell reception and turn it into an iPhone that is piggybacking off the cell reception that I'm already paying for. I'm here to, well, the first thing I'm here to do is see about taking an iPhone that has no cell reception and putting it on and piggyback off of the cell reception that I already pay for. I called mobile and they said we could do that. Well, $12 is still better than $40 for a whole second line for, yeah. Okay, I'm really happy with the way that happened. I'll talk more about it when I can. Okay, I'm home and happy. I'm really happy about how this went today. I was pretty nervous, as you know, because of the whole scheduling snafu, but it all worked out. Grocery delivery service showed up at like 10:45, and they were in and out before I had to leave. I went to the cable company / phone store, brought my dead iPhone over to their network. I kind of thought it would work, and it did in fact work. So we've breathed the life into that. It's actually not 100% free. It's $12 a month for something about data. But, you know, $58 for two cell phones is kick-ass deal. I mean, I certainly wasn't going to pay another $46 a month for a second line. And they're not asking for that from me. So I'm pretty satisfied. Not only that, but I was able to have that conversation with them that I wanted to have on Saturday. But when I called them, the computer at the call center would not let them see what other promos were available. So I went into the store. And while I was there, I was like, look, I'm not paying $200 a month for TV and internet. Is there any new promo available that I can pay like closer to what I'm paying now? And yes, there was. I'm in a 2-year contract where I'm paying $7 more than what I am now, as opposed to $27, which is what it would have been if I would have let that promo lapse and then said, whatever, I'll just keep paying what they're telling me to pay. No, I won't. $210? No way. So, I made out pretty well today. And I think that's a pretty good note to end this vlog on. Thank you for watching. Please follow me on Twitter, or if you must, on Facebook. Check out the description below for services and petitions that I believe in. And I'll see you in the next video when you hear what I have to say.